He whisked off her shoes and panties in one movement, wild like an enraged shark, his bulky totem beating a seductive rhythm. Mary's body felt like it was burning, even though the room was properly air-conditioned. They tried all the positions, on top, doggy and normal. Exhausted, they collapsed onto the recently extended sofa bed. Then a hellbeast ate them. Welcome, friend. I'm Garth Marenghi, horror writer, although I also pen westerns and erotica to keep my oar in with other fields of literature. I've always loved the great tragedies. King Lear, The Poseidon Adventure, Superman 2. And when I wrote, directed and starred in Garth Marenghi's Darkplace, I set out to continue that grand tradition. This Eve's Yarn is a simple tale of heartbreak. An eternal story of love and loss, set against the backdrop of an abortive alien invasion. Though you don't actually find out it's abortive till the end of the show. It's my Romeo and Juliet, but less whiny. So, dear pilgrim, I give you my hymn to the heart with horror, along with interviews from myself, my publisher Dean Lerner, and the actor Todd Rivers. That way you won't have to think for yourselves, which is probably safer. Hold it gently, as you wouldst a lover lying in a field, nestled in the shade of a mighty oak tree. Perhaps you're gently petting, having just enjoyed a hamper of chilled white wine and a selection of continental cheeses. Bon appetit.
I'm Garth Marenghi, author, dreamweaver, visionary, plus actor. You are about to enter the world of my imagination. You are entering my dark place.
Nature calls, if you know what I mean. I'll just leave you briefly by this air vent.
What is it?
I forgot to flush! Dr. Rick Douglas, M.D. Now! Yes, I'll hold.
The script to Shuggoth was based on an old sonnet sequence I wrote when I was 16.
I'm a language junkie. That's my hit. I get off on language. I mean, you know, just to think of that poem by Wordsworth. I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on higher vales and hills, when all at once I saw a cloud, a host of gleaming daffodils. You know, and to think that there weren't even rhyming dictionaries around when Bill wrote that is very humbling.
Garth is the most significant artist that I've ever worked with, and I've worked with Lulu and four other people. So we're talking creme de la creme.
My name is Dr. Rick Douglas, M.D. A woman turned green last night. The porter said he saw her breathe in a green gas. Could this be linked to the green cloud of gas that was directly over the hospital's ventilation shaft?
I was cruising down to Ward B to find out. I'd stopped out of my way to give Sanchez and Asher a lift, a courtesy for which they'd yet to thank me.
You're welcome.
What the hell's the matter with you, Dad?
Nothing. What are you doing for dinner tonight, Liz?
Nothing really. Why are you asking me out?
No. Just trying to get some recipe ideas. Finding food a real bore at the moment.
What I do is sometimes get a tin of soup,
yeah,
heat it up, poach an egg in it, serve that with a pork pie sausage roll.
I'll get a wimpy.
You're cold, Dag. Liz, fancy egg and soup? I'm free this evening.
No, I think I'll wash my hair.
Okay.
Plus, I've now got a headache.
Sure, whatever. I'll put some sounds on. There's a bad atmosphere in here.
Why won't she be mine? I wish I was more attractive like Douglas. Still, one can only dream.
I'm a one-track lover, down a two-way lane, driving fast down the highway, must have been insane. Cause the temperature's too high, traveling way too fast, and I knew our loving was too hot to last.
She's smooth like ice, cold to the touch, and it isn't very nice when you left alone. Your lady treats you badly, leaves you hanging on the phone. Take off, shove your loving on the wheel, put the pedal to the floor, cause you're heading for the hills. Gotta get away, can't take it no more. Man, you don't need this lever at the door.
The door, the door, the door.
Sanch, open the door. Open the door, Sanch, Sanch.
Sorry, Thornton. Bad dream.
Count yourself lucky.
Look at her.
It can happen. Like that. You can fall in love in an instant.
Todd's wonderful in this episode, and there are scenes with him and me where I think you're watching him as much as me.
Apparently she was in for a routine operation to have her toe shortened, which was really long, like a finger. The next thing she knew, this happened. All in all, she's a little off-colour.
You shut your mouth, Liz.
No, you shut your mouth, Sanch. That was funny. If we lose our sense of humour in this place, we might as well kill ourselves.
He's right, Sanch. One of the main reasons I went into medicine was for the laughs. That and the pussy. And that dried up 10 years ago, if you'll pardon the expression.
That may be so, but there's no reason to mock this poor woman's condition. Look, I'm going to stay with her, talk to her, help her. It's called a bedside manner, heard of it?
Heard of yours, pal.
I've had it with you clowns.
He's acting like a jerk. Come on, Liz. Coffee's on me.
But coffee's free here.
Shh. She don't know that. I'll look after Liz. You get this skin sample analysed. And keep this dumb. If Wonton gets wind of this, my arse is grass. And he's got a lawnmower. You dig?
10-4. Funny.
Hello, is that Gavin, the hospital gas expert? Well, can you put Gavin on? Hi, Gavin. Just a quick question to read that green gas in the sky last night. Sorry, I thought you were going to speak. Yeah. Could the green gas have contained cosmic fungi and or sent down spores? It could. And those fungal spores could infect a person? Only if the person had been left directly next to an air vent. Cheers, Gavin. I owe you a beer. Actually, you owe me one from before, so we're quits.
Broccoli. She's turning into broccoli.
Mmm, something smells good.
It's egg in soup.
Mmm.
Here, let me cut up your pork pie.
Whoops.
Ah, you've spilt. I'll get a nurse to have you out of that nightdress.
I think I'd be more comfortable with a doctor's touch.
As a horror writer, There are certain words you don't use when you're writing a sex scene. Balls, knickers, scrope. It's not clever, it's not sexy, it's bad writing.
I read modern writers and it's screw this, he licked her, she sucked that, he bit the other, you know, someone put it there, he held it. It was at this frequency. I mean, where's the sensuality?
Exactly, where's he glided in liquid smooth? Where's her wispy mound?
Where's her sacred V?
Honeyed lining.
Her mossy cleft.
Look at that. Makes you wonder what else is up there. All our broccoli must have come down from these skies billions of years ago. Over time, it's evolved, become less aggressive.
Broccoli from space. I wondered why it tasted odd.
This is serious, Thornton.
Come on, Dag, that was funny.
You're right, that was funny. I'm just worried about Sanch. How are we going to tell him that this time tomorrow the girl he loves will be a complete vegetable?
Broccoli.
I can cope with constant bereavement. He can't. Most people can't.
That's not all, Raiden Rick.
Isn't it?
No. Gavin, the hospital gas expert, just called. He handed me this.
Well, according to this, the broccoli spores can be passed on during the act of physical lovemaking.
But if it's passed to Sanchez, half of Romford could have it within the week.
If they have made love, there is a 50% chance Sanchez has got it.
Well, we're going to have to hope Sanchez dipped his wick. Otherwise, this could go nationwide.
Bang goes my Hippocratic oath.
Have you ever done that before?
What, making love?
No, I mean with a patient.
Once or twice, but they were dying. It was their last wish. But with you, it was real. I did it because you're different. Plus, I think I've got a thing for green women.
Hold me in your arms.
We don't even know each other's names.
Linda.
Dr. Sanchez.
Oh.
What is it?
I'm just so happy.
The cosmic spores, of course, represented AIDS.
I have had such terrible experiences with that, with the AIDS. I've lost so many friends to that terrible disease. My half-brother, who was such a promising dancer, very quietly, very peacefully, he went. And then Freddie went.
Back then, no one would touch this subject. You know, it was us and Princess Di.
What's the matter, Dag? You look like you got the weight of the world on your shoulders, if you catch my drift, as it were.
Have you ever been in love, Padre?
Only with the Holy Three.
It can make you feel like the king of the world, or...
a complete tool?
It's powerful stuff. My best friend's woman's gonna die. She's turning into broccoli.
Oh, Jesus Christi.
It's taking her over. It's very infectious, Padre. And I fear the only way to stop this spreading will be to boil her.
You could steam her.
How does one weigh the happiness of these two star-crossed lovers, Romeo and Juliet, against the future of Romford?
You'll know what to do. You're the most sensitive man I know. And I know God.
Thanks for the advice. I knew I'd be right.
Come on. Come to Padre. Embrace the infinite. That's it. Oh, come on. If you need me, I'll be right here in the vestry. If not, I'll be out in the Jeep.
Cheers, Padre.
Stay holy.
Amen.
When I pray, and sometimes I do, I pray to myself. I pray that I can pull myself through. And if I'm lucky, I answer myself.
Champagne on ice at bed 395 and make sure it's in the bucket. I want to surprise Linda. And now I'll have a double scotch and I imagine my good friend here will have the same. She's a hell of a woman. To Linda and her speedy recovery.
Yeah. How can I tell him she's dying? It'll tear him apart.
Sanj, I just saw Linda. She told me to tell you that she doesn't love you and that you should forget anything ever happened because it was meaningless. I'm sorry, buddy.
That's a goddamn lie. You can't stand it, can you, Dag? You can't stand it that this time I got the girl.
Don't walk away from me, lover boy.
I suggest you remove your hand or so help me God, I'll knock you down.
You're gonna have to make me.
Okay, buddy, let's dance.
Jesus, been in the gym.
Nice shot, buddy.
Look, I'll level with you. Linda's dying. She's turning into broccoli. It's very contagious. She must be boiled.
Boil Linda over my dead body, you bastard. Okay. Come on.
You two, this is a hospital.
He's out of line.
I'm out of line. He's out of line.
You're both out of line. Now, I'm not going to stand here and dance for you. I don't have to. I want to see both of you in my office 5 minutes ago. So you'd best hurry up. Look, Sanch, I know all about Linda, and I'm sorry, God knows I am, but slapping Dag's ass about the shop ain't gonna bring her back any. Now, if Dag thinks that the only way to contain this is to boil her, then I'm backing him 110%. That means I could backtrack 10%, and I'd still be completely behind him.
You have no idea what this feels like, old-timer.
I've been there, hombre. When I heard my wife died, I could barely finish my lunch. But right now, Dag and I are more worried about your downstairs area.
Sanch, we know what's up with your meeting too. I saw you and the gents.
Mild discomfort, nothing I can't handle.
Tell Reed what colour it is.
Olive green, what of it?
Look, we're gonna have to lop it off, otherwise it'll spread. Now, I've asked Reed to assist me in the operation.
That rusty general, he's not been in surgery in 10 years.
I've had first-hand experience. I lost a ball in career. Had to do the op myself.
That was one ball. This is the whole 9 yards. No way am I letting him near the old boy.
I'd offer you my own if I could, but this is the only way.
It's the only way, Sanch. Otherwise it'll spread.
You're not getting my rub without a fight.
The next sequence in the show, alas, is lost. The pertaining can of film was destroyed in a drink-related misadventure in Fulham. It was an idiotic altercation, which I bitterly regret, both for personal and professional reasons. However, with the aid of some photographic stills taken by the girlfriend of the time, we have reconstructed the missing scenes with added narration from the available cast. I hope that this does not impair your enjoyment of the drama.
Sanchez lunges at Reed, but is held down by Douglas.
Don't touch it,
Sanchez says. Reed calls for backup, and a general anaesthetic is administered by a hospital orderly. Meanwhile, Linda's condition worsens. Sanchez is rushed to surgery in a race against time to stop the infection spreading. Reluctantly and with some difficulty, Douglas and Reed remove the affected penis and leave Sanchez to recuperate. However, it is now too late for Linda.
Hello, Linda. You look better. Do you feel you're getting better? Now, I've run some tests, and you're going to have a long sleep, and then you're going to wake up again right as rain. And Sanchez will be with you, and you'll have a great future together. Sanch would be here, but he's out on his rounds helping some crippled children right now. Can't get him to shut up talking about you. You found yourself a good man. Guy happens to be my best bud in the whole world. What's this?
It's a dream catcher.
What's a dream catcher?
It's like a wind chime.
Then why don't you say wind chime? Thank you. Sanch will love this. He loves wind, and he loves the sound of tinkling, and he loves you.
As Linda breathed her last green breath, the cloud disappeared, much like the Scotch mist did last week. And I went back to my humble doctor's duties.
Thanks for saving my life.
You're welcome, little man. He's a good kid. You've got to keep him off the smack, though, otherwise this will keep happening. Maybe you should try and get a husband, get some stability in your life, okay? Excuse me. Take it from Rick, I will not rest until I've found you an adequate replacement. Linda asked me to give you this.
What is it?
It's a dream catcher.
What's a dream catcher?
It's like a wind chime.
I think you should have it. For saving my life.
Thanks, Sanchez.
Wait! Thanks for that lift.
Don't mention it.
Broccoli had gone, but the hurt remained. For all of us, not just Sanchez. Darkplace was finding ways of getting to us from within, and what we had to fear most was ourselves. That and AIDS. If you want it, wear one. Sex, that is, not AIDS. No one wants AIDS. I guess I was going to have to look out for everyone. Not that I get any thanks.
With this show, I wanted to make people laugh and cry and shit themselves at the same time.
I fear that we are seeing an end to the quality of television that you and I should be able to take for granted. We are seeing a dumbing down of television. I think we're living in dangerous times. The horror genre is in decline. Reading is in decline. Literacy, numeracy, the three L's are in decline.
You and he were buddies, weren't you?
Need I say more? Need I say more?
We didn't know what it was going to achieve in the long run. We didn't know it would still be, you know, talked about these days.
Garth's place in history is assured. His place in history is assured.
As a horror writer, I don't ask for much. I just hope I've changed the way you think about life.
I'm a one-track lover, down a two-way lane, driving fast down the highway, must have been insane, 'cause the temperature's too high, traveling way too fast, and I knew our love was too hot.
Garth Marenghi's Darkplace is a Garth Marenghi production in association with Dean Lennon.